They're known for beautiful displays in the sky. But it wasn't that kind of explosion that put the Bartolotta family to the ultimate test.
Next on 12 News at 5, live team coverage on a fire at the Bartolotta Fireworks Factory.
You just remember what you were doing, what everything smelled like, what it looked like, what, you know, I could remember it perfectly.
And he always will. Nick Bartolotta has the mental and physical scars to remind him.
I'm a professional patient right now. I do my therapy every day. I go see, got a couple different doctors I see.
Last November, Nick, his brother Tony, and their cousin Rocco were working at the Bartolotta Fireworks Factory in Waukesha County.
We were making a product for a blasting company. We weren't making fireworks.
For some reason, the device Rocco was working on ignited, sparking a flash fire.
When that ignited in my hand, I dropped it, and the next thing I remember, the whole building, I mean, I couldn't see anything other than flames.
All I know is it happened really fast, and there wasn't a lot of time for us to react, and we all got out as quickly as humanly possible.
Within minutes, the building was destroyed, and three lives were changed forever.
And it's a miracle all three of us are here talking to you today, because we should be dead, all three of us.
There you go!
It really is a miracle.
Easy, easy.
That these men can now enjoy a day at play, taking in the simple pleasures of softball, not letting themselves be benched by their injuries.
I think it burned to the muscle. Like my lower eyelids burned off, and then tops of my ears burned off, and they redid those, and the end of my nose they redid.
Nick spent weeks at Columbia St. Mary's burn unit. He's had a dozen surgeries, skin grafts, and he goes to therapy every day. But still, he's trying to stay positive.
You can cry about, you know, oh, woe is me and how bad it is, but, you know, it beats the alternative of that, you know, at least you have this chance to get better and stuff.
Besides the physical pain, there's emotional hurt that goes along with his appearance.
My kids are 11 and 7, and they're at the age where kids are still mean, you know, where they say, what's wrong with your dad, you know, and I know that makes them feel bad, so they've done real well with coping with the whole thing.
Rocco has been dealing with third-degree burns on his hands and arms.
The biggest thing is to get my arms back to being as normal as possible.
He, too, spent weeks in the hospital. He's had surgery after surgery. He's still going through therapy, and his skin doesn't want to bend. It sometimes rips when he tries to move.
The pain is almost on an everyday basis, and it has gotten better, but I still wake up, and my arms are locked in a position like this.
Rocco's mind isn't free either. He's always afraid.
The hardest thing for me right now to deal with is during severe weather, when we get lightning, the lightning reminds me of the flash of the fire.
The fire left Tony with less severe burns on his face and hand.
Yeah, I healed. Yeah. It was all superficial, pretty much superficial burns.
But Tony's heart hasn't healed. He deals with tremendous guilt.
It doesn't make a lot of sense because we were all in the same place, and I don't know, nobody can explain it, but I was lucky. I should count my blessings, but some days I don't. Some days I go, maybe I should have been hurt instead of my brother or my cousin, or, you know, so it's hard.
But the team spirit of the Bartolotta family has not been injured. They are rooting for each other in the game of life.
Here it goes.
Hoping to score a total recovery.
We're getting by the best we can.
Kind of just got to take it day by day.
Life can change like that. You got to be ready.